Chevrolet Impala has been so mediocre for so long, it's actually hard to imagine as being new. Not only that, but towards the end of the last generation, it became the darling of rental fleets everywhere. Meanwhile, the competition stepped up its game. The Chrysler 300, Toyota Avalon, Ford Taurus, and other competitors have become better. And there's a newcomer, the Kia Cadenza. So can the new Impala fast forward over the past and take on the competition? Hi, I'm Joel Fetter, and we'll take a look at this and more in our video road test of the 2014 Chevrolet Impala. Chevrolet has chucked the past when it comes to design for the new Impala. We really like the crisply themed sheet metal, and we'd like to see it elsewhere in the bow ties lineup. Up front, this shovel nose might as well be wearing a Honda badge. And those headlights, they should be wearing Saab logos. On the sides and in the back, those rear haunches, they really mimic a lot of lines in the Mercedes-Benz CLS, and we can technically see some aspects of the Buick LaCrosse back there. Frankly, this is GM's best effort at distinguishing the brands with design language, and we'd like to see it employed elsewhere. Meanwhile, the interior ebbs and flows. The design constantly keeps your eyes moving. Now, it's nowhere as glitzy as the Avalon, but the materials are really nicely done, and we like this big gauge cluster. It's easy to read. But in our heart of hearts, we've got to believe there's an easier way to pull out the dramatic look without being so busy. It could be calmer. There's just so many cut lines. The Impala is a full-size car, and in fact, it's really not a lot larger than the Volkswagen Passat, Hyundai Azera, or Toyota Avalon. But it shames the inefficient layout of the Taurus by having a lot of interior room with efficient packaging. Now up front, there's a lot of legroom, 3.5 inches more than the last generation. And in back, there's about 2.2 inches more than the last generation. In fact, we're only about an inch or two shy of limousine status back here when we're talking about legroom. Now, tall passengers could have a problem with the shape of the roof line. It's a fastback in some regard. And also, this bench seat is really flat and a bit short for how large the car is, so it can be uncomfortable for some passengers. It's a little flat. Even with five passengers, the Impala is comfy, and there are a ton of cargo bins for the knickknacks. The trunk is a whopping 18.8 cubic feet, which is second only to the Taurus's 20 cubic feet. Under the hood of Chevrolet Impala, you'll find one of three engines. Now the base unit is a 2.5 liter four-cylinder engine rated 195 horsepower. Our tester features the 3.6 liter V6 engine rated 305 horsepower. There's also an Eco model that features GM's mild hybrid system called eAssist, and is powered by a 2.4 liter four-cylinder engine mated to an electric assist system for 182 horsepower. All Impalas have a 6-speed automatic transmission with manual shift capabilities, but it's on top of the automatic transmission gear shift lever, you know, where no one's ever going to use it. The V6 engine's fuel economy is slightly behind the competition at 19 city, 29 highway, and 22 combined. That's about a digit or two lower than the Azera and Avalon, and the 35 mile per gallon highway rating that Chevy is expecting the mild hybrid Eco model to return is well off the Avalon Hybrid's 40 mile per gallon rating. Opting for the base four-cylinder model only brings those ratings to 21-31 with 25 miles per gallon combined. Now let's be clear, the Impala is far from a road-going land yacht. In fact, if you get the V6 engine, there's even a little engine rasp. We like that. Now, the four-cylinder engine, it has enough power for everyday use for the most part. In fact, you can even spin the inside wheel. But when you really need the power to merge or pass or anything like that, the transmission scrambles a downshift and it just really isn't there. The four-cylinder also has active noise cancellation, and that'll make it so you really just don't cringe when the engine's lugging along at 1,500 RPMs. The Impala actually has really good ride composure, and it's impressive from where it's come from. The Impala has the motions and balance and handling that, just by a factor of a few, the Azera, Avalon, Taurus just miss here and there. For 2014, the Impala stepped up its safety game, from 10 airbags to standard OnStar, and it's already earned a good rating from the IIHS in its crash tests. It's also got a lot of available new safety technology, from adaptive cruise control, blind spot monitoring, lane departure warning, forward collision warning, backup sensors, and a rear view camera. It's got you covered. Now, like other Chevrolet models, the Impala is available in three trim levels, an LS, an LT, and an LTZ. Now, if you want a V6 engine, you're going straight to the LT or LTZ. The LS model, the base one, starts at about $27,500. That includes power locks, windows, mirrors, cruise control, and 18-inch alloy wheels. Stepping up to the LT model with a V6, like ours, it's about 30 grand. That has Chevrolet's MyLink infotainment system as standard, and the screen for that actually slides up. There's a lockable storage unit behind it, and you can put your iPhone or other things inside it and it slides back down. Navigation is available, and a power driver's seat comes along with. Now, a fully loaded LTZ model is going to be about 40 grand plus, and that gives you everything from navigation to the Chevrolet MyLink system to 20-inch alloy wheels to power driver's seat to ventilated and heated seats in the front. So what's the bottom line with the 2014 Chevrolet Impala? It finally leaps past its history with fine handling and even better styling. For all the latest automotive news and reviews, be sure you're following us on Twitter, on Facebook, and on YouTube. I'm Joel Fetter. Thanks for watching.